Hello students, my name is Bharti Bhaskar. I welcome you again. First, I would like to teach you organization in living things, lesson 1 of class 7. So, before explaining anything else, first I would like to ask you, what are living things? What are living things, children? Of course, you know it. Living things are those things which can grow, respire, reproduce, respond to stimuli, they can move, etc. Living things are of two types. First one, microscopic. They are very small sized. And the second one is macroscopic. These are large sized organisms. And can you see by our naked eyes? So as you know children, living things are made up of a microscopic small unit which is called cell. So what is cell? Do you know? Yes, you know. Cell can perform basic activities of our life. First, it is discovered by scientist Robert Hooke. In 1665. So the word cell, it is a Latin word cellula. Cellula means small room or compartments. These compartments give the appearance of honeycomb like this. When we see these cells under microscope, it will give the appearance of this type. These are the honeycombs. So children, have you seen the construction of buildings? What is the basic material by which they constructed? They constructed by a material which is called brick. So as the buildings made up by bricks, our body is also made up by a building block material which is called cell. So these cells make our body structure. The whole body structure is made up of cell in every living thing. Either it is plant or animals or human being. So have you understood what is cell? I hope you understood. Next, cell. Children's cells organize to form tissues. tissues or dice to form organ. Organs or dice to form organ system. Children, after cell, I am going to teach you tissue. Tissue. A tissue is a group of okay, children. So tissue. A tissue is a group of cells specialized for a particular function or a set of functions of similar nature. So children, I'm going to teach you tissue in plants. Plant tissues are of two types. Meristematic tissue and second one is permanent tissue. Children, meristematic tissues have the capacity, ability to divide. They are the dividing tissue. But children, permanent tissue do not have the ability to divide. They are non-dividing tissue. They can divide. The cells of this tissue have the ability to divide till maturity. Permanent tissue is a non-dividing tissue. In permanent tissue, cells lost their ability to divide. So children, today I taught you plant tissue. There are two types, meristematic and permanent. But children, these meristematic and permanent tissues are also subdivided into many types. So these types I will explain you in my next video. Till then, stay home.